Well, this is a new one on me. Time now.
200 feet, turn right, Emsall Drive. Turn right.
The time now is 3:15. I got in there. And what time did I get in there? About 11:30, something like that. Ish. So, best part of nearly 4 hours.
After 600 feet, cross the roundabout and take the second exit, A638 Doncaster Road.
And,
cross the roundabout and take the second exit.
So you can pull into a lay-by in a minute and finish off the old paperwork after all of that. So yeah, the load was rejected because
A638 Doncaster Road towards Doncaster for 3 miles.
It wasn't on a pallet. Yep. Just boxes in the back of the container, like 95% of them are, because they can get more in. And it's just cartons, it's just boxes of stuff. And that's how it generally is. So they've got the machinery. They've got the conveyor belts that go into the back of the truck. They've got all top-notch machinery to unload. And they wouldn't. So I'm just going to dive in here a minute. Just finish off the paperwork. Pearl's gone home. Pearl's a singer. Oh, well, not the day she ain't. She ain't even a cafe operator. Right, so yeah, heading back down with a full load. I'll speak to you later on. Hello, back again. I just had to put another seal on because they cut the seals obviously to go in the back. And then said, do it. They're really odd. He said, is it? They said to me, is it seal? Is it the first thing they said to me was, is it pallets or boxes? I said, I don't know, it's in a sealed container, mate. How would I know? He said, well, if it's boxes, we won't be taking it. I said, well, once you cut the seal, it's yours. So they cut the seal. Nah, I'm not taking it. So, but you just cut the seals. So a lot of phone calls, a lot of to-ing and fro-ing. Management got involved. And they would not take it. It's like, I can't believe you guys. So if you wonder why the cost of goods are going up, there's a prime example of why the cost of goods are going up. Because I'm having to drive all the way back down to Southampton now. With the same full box. And then find out where they're going to dump the box after that. But it's back down to Southampton. I won't be down there till tomorrow morning now. 8 o'clock at the earliest. What can you do? Hey. So I might get to junction 23. That's what I'm hoping for. But you never know where we might end up. I said, didn't I say on approach, the bigger the place, the greater the fuckwittery. Well, that born true, didn't it? I spoke to the manager and I said, yeah, but we haven't got the manpower. I said, two of your boys have been sat over there doing nothing for the last hour and a half. No, they haven't. I said, well, I've got it on camera. My truck camera's probably running. I said, I can see that they have. They said, oh, it'll take 2 to 3 hours to unload. I said, well, they've been sat out there for 2 hours. Could have been 2/3 of the way done. There's no real lifting involved, it's just like you slide it down a conveyor belt, automated conveyor belt, and you lift it off down the bottom, you stack it. I really don't see that.
Oh no, we're not doing that.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit towards the south, then at the end of the road, turn left.
You, there was no reasoning with them. It was like, no, we're just not doing it. It should be on pallets. We haven't got the manpower. I said, what? Two blokes sat there doing nothing. What do you mean you haven't got the manpower? Gave up in the end. Went back and sat in the truck.
Go left on the roundabout and take the first exit. Then, at the end of the road, turn left.
I recognise that.
Turn left A1M towards the south, then take the motorway.
Can't see if there's anything coming, don't think there is. No, can't see nothing. That's a bad junction. I've been here before. I haven't been to that place before though. Definitely been here on the motorway from here before. I was hoping I was going to stay in the stockyard tonight.
Follow A1M towards the south for 7.5 miles.
Danny A1, I'll speak to you all in a bit. Hello. So I'm on the M18 and I'm going to try and get to Shepshed Junction. 29, I think, Shepshed. 29. Well, the service is at Junction 29, whichever one that is. Or is Shepshed 23? I don't know. I think that is Shepshed, I think that's some. Shepshed's 23. I'll have to have a look and see which one is which. I can't remember. I'm not going to get into Shep Shed. Gone 5 o'clock. You know, chances are I'm not going to be able to get parked. That ain't going to happen. Anyway, yeah, just heading down the road. I'll speak to you all later. Hello, time now 16:26. Just going past Nottingham-ish. About 10 mile away from Shep Shed. Nottingham to my left. Pick up our daughter from Nottingham Uni on Saturday. And then she's finished, she's done. She's going to work the summer and then she's going travelling apparently. So, fair play to her. Lloyd Chester to Cheshire. Well, if I'd have been in the stockyard, I'd have had a quite depressing really. I'd have had a carvery tonight. Pork, beef. Heard a nice crackling. Roast potatoes, cauliflower cheese. No. I think I got a chicken salad. I'll be glad to pull over. Now, sitting around for that period of time is a killer. So if I'd have been tipping, I would have just climbed on me, but gone to sleep. But you know, I'm waiting all the time, waiting to come and see me, waiting for a phone call, just waiting. You can't just, you know. Can't relax. Whereas if you're tipping, you know that you're going to be, you know, they're going to be a couple of hours, so you've got at least an hour to
after
an hour and a half.
1.2 miles, take the exit 1B6540 towards Long Eaton. Follow M1 towards Leicester for 51 miles.
What are you talking about, girl? Talking nonsense. Let you out and you hang me out to dry. I'm up the nailing to get by, you know. Cheers for that. Steady Eddie up ahead. Leave it to the last minute, come into my lane, couldn't surprise me. I was going to leave it even later. later. Yeah, leave it even later. Yeah, now he's coming out. Under 5 miles to go. They haven't told me what I've got tomorrow. I said I'd see him in the office about 8 o'clock. Slow little Peugeot. He's talking to himself. Waving his arms about. A bit of a ball ache going that slow. Now I'm doing 56, so what's he doing? 50, 51, 52 maybe at a push. Not on a motorway, you know, you don't go that slow on a motorway. It's not that warm. It's warm in here behind the glass. Miles till I come off, and then it's literally just round the corner. Bit of headache. Glad to stop today. Hopefully we can get parked up. Two weeks to go to our holiday. 2 weeks. I've got 9 working days left. ship shed. I wonder if that was originally sheep shed. It just some illiterate sign writer. Mobile homes, they had to try and overtake me and get in the outside lane.
Cross the roundabout and take the second exit, N1, towards Leicester,
no.
Then
shut
take
up.
The motorway.
No. I'm about 150 miles away. Well, 156. Just under 156 miles. 155 miles away. Bit of a queue. Jan de Riek. Crazy Dutch. They do a lot of it's the aerospace division, and they do aircraft engines all over Europe. They often go down to I was talking to one of the lads a while back. He's saying, you know, they go down to Turkey or Greece or somewhere like that. It was either Turkey or Greece. And they take an engine. Oh, look at the traffic here. Look. Shitty death. They take an engine down all the way down to Turkey or Greece. And then they, it's like a one-for-one swap. One comes out, another one goes on. Well, they take an engine down. One comes off the plane. And then the one that's on the truck goes on the plane, and the one that comes off the plane goes on the truck. But that can take up to 10, 12 days. So whilst they're down there, they just wait it out. Oh, this is ridiculous. What is going on? Ugh. Okay. Well, that's where I want to go, up where all that traffic's going. So it's only literally 2 minutes up the road, but it might take me 20 minutes to get there. Come on, mate. Yeah, we can't really go, can we? Need a bit of a gap. Oh, and you can go. And I can go as well. We're good. Go on you go. On you go. A little bit further. So this place is on snap. So it's on account. I can hear sirens now, where are they coming from? No idea, ambulance coming by. Plenty of room. There you go. Go on, get on that siren, my son. That's it. Go on, get on it. Must be an accident down there. Here we go. Need a wee. Somebody said I didn't sound very happy the other day in one of my previous videos. No, I'm not really that happy at the moment, I'll be honest with you. I'm not enjoying it. I'm not enjoying what I'm doing. Not enjoying being away from home so much. You know, I've been tramping for 4 years now, and I live out of a bag. My bag at the weekends never gets unpacked. It just, you know, I have two bags. I take two bags. So well, no, I take more than two bags. So I take my laptop and food bags and all the rest of it. But I've got one bag that I keep all my clothes in, and then I've got another fold-up bag that I put all my dirty clothes in. So I take both home, and then all the clothes gets washed over the weekend, and then it all goes back into my bag again on the Sunday. And I never unpack my bags. I've been living out of a bag for basically 4 years. And I've got a bit tired of it, to be totally honest with you. It's not fun anymore. Yeah, I've done it, been there, done it. It served its purpose.
After a quarter of a mile, turn left, B591, Inglebury Road.
No, and that's it. Come on, little blue car. All goes into one lane here. Oh, Fred Sherwood, he's going to get in before me now, isn't he? Freddy. We're nearly there. Green light. Come on, son. Well done, Mr. Mercedes. He decided to hold back completely. I'm going in here.
After 900 feet, turn left, B591, Ingleberry Road.
Well, I can't get round with them two there. Go. Go. Junction 23, truck stop. Well, see, the cyclist cycling up the wrong side of the road. Okay. What's it like in there? Oh, it's looking quite busy actually.
After 900 feet, turn around when possible.
No, shut up. What are they doing? Are they, what are you doing? You going in? Place to park. There's nobody in there. Idiot. What a place to park. Oh my word. Where's he going? Going in somewhere, is he? Going in there? Yep, he's going in there. Close to his wing mirror. Wow. How close he is. Oh, you're gonna cause yourself a problem in a minute. Oh my word. Hey, sort it out. Got round here. There's a whole load there. What he's doing. Just get in a bay man, will ya? I no one wants to be near the fridge. Come on, what are you doing? What are you doing? Oh, somebody's fucking about round the corner there. What are they doing? What are they doing? You can get round on that. Ridiculous. Right, that's where I'm going next to him. He's making life very difficult for himself. Ain't getting on that. Oh my son, you getting on that? Go straight back. That's all you gotta do is go straight back. Go on. Where are you going? Which one are you going for?
Well, because he's
gone
in
there,
I can't
get around here. I'm going that one there, mate. What about that one there? Going there. You going that one, I'm going to go in this one here. Alright. Oh, yeah, no rush, fella.
That one or this one?
That other one.
This one?
No, the other one, this side. Yeah, far side. That's got to straighten up a bit, that's all.
Hey?
No one getting your doors.
No.
You won't believe I pulled into next RDC today.
Yeah.
I'm in the back up and says, oh, we won't fucking get that, mate. What's that? It's not on pallets. It's in the back. It's in the fucking building. I'm gonna run through this shit.
So why don't I know?
I don't know how he's going to get out. He's got my block in, isn't he? I don't know what he's going to do. Oh, you alright?
Where's he going?
Hey? No, he said it was alright. I reckon he's got just enough room to get out of it. He fucking does.
Richard, there's nothing in here.
Well, that's what he needs, a little one, isn't it?
Yeah. So he might go in. He's fairly. We watch him.
Yeah, if he comes back in state, he should be alright, shouldn't he? I don't know where he's going backwards.
You've got to get in here early, haven't you? I've never stopped in here in my life. I've been not, though. I've been here for food and that, but never slept in here. It's not too bad, they get fridges in here. And you get the old Fred Sherwood to come in with all the waste, fucking flies.
That's the worst thing. But it looks like we should be alright up here.
Thank you.
quarter past five, six, seven, eight, nine, ten, 11, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12, 12